In this video, we will learn how to set up bank feeds for the desktop version of QuickBooks. The setup steps are very simple. First, you call your financial institution to confirm that you will be downloading transactions from your online banking into your QuickBooks file, and they will activate the service. You might have to pay a fee. You then go to the bank feeds in the main menu and select your financial institution. This means choose your bank or PayPal or whomever you do your banking with. In my example, I'll be using my Chase online bank account on my QuickBooks desktop. Once they're downloaded, you match the accounts in your QuickBooks file to the accounts in your online banking. This way, QuickBooks knows which particular bank account online goes to which particular account in your chart of accounts. So from the main menu, click Banking, Bank Feeds, Set up Bank Feeds for an account. Now, of course, you see QuickBooks is connecting to the internet and it's finding out which financial institutions make this service available. After it connects, the first thing it asks you to do is type in the name of your financial institution. I happen to know if you have Chase Bank, you should not choose JP Morgan from this list. You should choose Chase. I was told that by the customer service representatives when I originally tried to connect my QuickBooks. So if you have a different financial institution, you will have to follow their instructions. I click Chase, and now it's going to ask me my Chase username and password. Of course, it tells you all the different pieces of information you might need, and of course, in the case of Chase Bank, there's a specific customer service number you could call for this particular service if you have a problem setting it up. I'm going to click Continue, and now I'm going to put in my username and password, and of course it'll be blurred out, but you get the idea. Then I click Connect, and then I get this screen. And this screen is asking me to match my particular bank accounts and credit card accounts over at Chase match with the accounts that are bank type of accounts in the QuickBooks file that I am currently in. So I already set up the QuickBooks chart of accounts to have the matching numbers. So premium plus checking is 8205. So let's see, premium checking 8205. What about business checking 3565, business checking 3565, and so on. These are my three Chase bank accounts, Chase credit card accounts, and I would, if they were company credit card accounts, I would match them to company credit card accounts the same way. After I match the accounts online to the accounts in my QuickBooks, I click Connect. Then I confirm and I click Close. Congratulations. This current QuickBooks file is now connected to the online banking center for my bank. Now you'll notice that your bank feeds menu now includes the bank feed center. Let's take a look. Okay, from the main menu, click Banking, Bank Feeds, and this choice is here. Bank Feed Center is a brand new menu choice now that you set it up. When we click, we look at the Bank Feed Center. Now let's talk about this button over here, Download Transactions. You see, the Download Transactions button will only say Download Transactions if the review list, meaning the list that you downloaded from your bank to review, only if that list is empty. If that list is not empty, it will say Transaction List instead of Download Transactions. So let's take a look. We come back to QuickBooks, and you can see these are the two bank accounts that are connected to the QuickBooks accounts. And now I'm going to click, here, I'll have to move this slightly over a little here, and I'll click Download Transactions. Okay, oops, got to put the PIN or password for the bank account each time that you download. Okay. Now you can see it's updating the transactions. 138 new transactions for account business checking 3565. Click close. And now you can see the button no longer says download transactions. It says transaction list. And if we click on it, we get a list of the transactions that were downloaded into a file, but they are not in QuickBooks yet. Now in this video, we will not take any action. I just want to show you how to navigate the transaction list that opens in the Bank Feed Center. It's very simple. You can see it's arranged in date order from the earliest, because I'm filming today on July 12th, all the way back to the latest it could possibly go to, which in this case is July of 2015. So I have 137 transactions spread out over 2 years, basically 2 years worth of transactions, earliest to oldest. I could flip that. I can make it the oldest to the earliest by clicking the date heading and on top of the date column. Watch, it'll flip from July of 2017 to July of 2015. Date. See? Now it's from oldest to newest. And the 2017 ones are down at the bottom. So I'm going to click once to flip it back. You could also arrange it by type by filtering it out. Some are deposits and some are checks and payments. If you click all types and you click check, you'll get only the payments and nothing else. No deposits or any other kind of special entries. If you flip it and you say, I want to see only the deposits, then you'll see only the deposits. And again, whatever you choose will be earliest to oldest. What if you, actually we should switch it back to all types to make it clear. Another nice thing is that you can change the date range. You can see QuickBooks knows this goes from July of 2015 to July of 2017. But if we want only June of 2016, we could simply move this forward, for example, you know, to June of 2016, June 1, June of 2016, this one you should make June 30th. And now that there were only two transactions in this account during the month of June 2016. So you could always change the date range back. You could either type it in or just click really fast to go back to the beginning. I believe it was July of 2015 to July of 2017. And here we are. And now we have all the transactions again. Now, you may also notice that you can filter by the status. Now, right now, we only have transactions that need review. But in future videos, I will be talking about auto match, and you could filter it down to see only the ones that are auto matched. In future videos, I'll be talking about those that were changed by rules, and you could see only those if you want to. You should note that no transaction will be entered into QuickBooks without approval. What you'll have to do is take some action. You have a choice of adding the transaction as is, because sometimes QuickBooks will suggest the information to put in, and then you can just click Add Is. You could modify the transaction as you add. You can apply the checks to bills that you want to pay, or you can apply deposits to invoices that you sent out to customers, which, by the way, this is a new feature since 2014. You could match the transactions in the review list to existing transactions that you have already entered in QuickBooks, or you could ignore. And all of these options are things that we will explore in future videos. The way to take action on one of these items is to click in the row of the item and go all the way across to the column of action. Then you choose what you want to do with it. Do you want to add it? Do you want to add more details? Do you want to pay bills or apply to invoices? Do you want to match it to an existing transaction that you entered or ignore it completely because it might be wrong, or you might not want to match it because you might have other reasons? And we'll talk about those reasons in future videos. Okay, the only remaining thing that I want to show you about this transaction list window, which is basically the review list, are the two fields that reflect the description from the bank. Now I'm going to show you inside my Chase activity of my actual business bank account. And as you can see, first of all, you can see I'm very unsuccessful in business, but that's not the point. The point is that these are the transactions in my business checking account that was just downloaded. And of course it has the date and the type, description, debit, credit, and the balance. The most important thing I'd like you to pay attention to is the description field. The description field that comes from the bank is the most important field, and you will see why this is in later videos. But I have to show you something very important. The entire description in the one description field in the bank account is actually split into two different fields in the transaction list and the review list. You might think that the field called downloaded as is the same as the description. Look, 7-Eleven Chase QuickPay Electronic TR. Oh, let's just make the column wider, the same way you would in reports or in Excel. Move the mouse between the column headings till you get the double arrow, click and drag and make it wider. Now I made it much wider, but you can still see it's not the complete description. Chase QuickPay Electronic Transfer. That's cut off. Chase QuickPay Electronic Transfer, and it shows all the information. So what do we need to do to get the rest of the information in? There's a box here you can click the check mark, Show Bank Memo. And that basically, well, we have to stretch this out. That basically shows you the other half of the bank's description. It's the other half. In fact, if I change the column width, I could fit it perfectly, but I would have to go transaction by transaction. So it's really unusual. It makes you click this check mark to see the remainder of the bank memo or the bank description in this field that doesn't show. And the first half of the description shows in this field, which is cut off. So you have to click this check mark and widen this column in order to make sure that you can see the entire description. Look, I'll prove it to you. This next one was an online payment to American Express, and this is the entire text written out. Now when I look at that same transaction in the Bank Feed Center, online payment to Capital One by Power Card. Okay, that's the $30 on the 5th. Am I looking at the right one? Yeah, it's this one. This one's the $30 on the 5th. The $45 bill payment to American Express, well, let's see. Actually, that's this one. Online payment to American Express. So you can see that this very important column that shows the entire description, very important, becomes challenging because it's split between two fields, one of which you have to click to show, and the other you have to stretch to see the whole thing. Please note, each transaction can be downloaded only once. If you deleted it from QuickBooks or clicked ignore in the transaction list, you cannot download it ever again. You would have to enter it manually or download a Web Connect file from your bank. And we will be talking about Web Connect files and all of these scenarios in future videos in this course.